Hello, class. This is your instructor, Timothy Davis. And for this video, I want to show you how to create an APA formatted document using Google Docs. As you can see, I have named, I'm already in Google Docs, and I have named this document APA template. So this will be in our folder. But you can always watch this video as well, just in case you want to know how to do it on your own. So whether you're familiar with Google Docs or not, I think this video will be very helpful. As you can see, I'm already in Google Docs. I've already named my document. But let's get started. I have one page here, and in APA, the first page is always essential. It's your title page. So what you want to do is create that. So the default setting for Google Docs is Arial 11 points. So you want to change that to Times New Roman 12 point. And then you'll want to, of course, get everything in double space. So you want to come down here to line spacing and double space it. And then of course with APA you'll need your running head. So for here, to do that in Google Docs, just click up, well, maybe that won't work. You want to insert page number. And then this is very important. You see right here it says different first page header footer. You always want that clicked. And then it goes back to the default setting, which you can change to this. And you want to type in your running head. We'll just say sorry, I didn't hit all caps, it goes to the machine. And then you want tab over to here, and then you can click out of that, and then you want to center your cursor, and you want to go down to about right here. That's good enough. And then you type your title again. Notice it is not in all caps because it shouldn't be. Oh well, just do this. Your name goes here, not my name, and then you want institutional affiliation, College of Western Idaho. Now you're done with the first page. So for the first page, you should have the words running head, colon, and then whatever your title is. If your title is rats, or it's zoology, the study of trilobites, or whatever your title is, that should be right here. And then you have page number one, because this is your first page. And then you go down to about it's 2 inches, but this right here, this is perfect. Google Docs doesn't do like Microsoft Word, where there can be a ruler right here that allows you to measure where everything is. That would be really helpful, and I'm not sure where that is. I've looked in Vue or in places like that, but I can't seem to find it. So this is a good spot right here for your title. You don't want it all the way down here, and you don't want it all the way up here. You want it right here. And then what you'll want to do is go to the second page. So you go to insert, do a page break. And you'll notice that there is a 2 right here. That means you did your running head correctly. So we'll address that in, well, right now. So if you've done everything correctly, you should have a 2 right here. And don't worry if you didn't do it correctly. You can always fix it. But for page 2, just click up there. And it should take you up there. Move it to the left And then you want the same title, just not the words running head, because you don't need them anymore. There you go. If you hit the tab one more time, it'll push it over to there. That is incorrect. So you want it right about here. And then you want your title again. If you have to write an abstract, this would be your abstract page. But for this class, the only time you're going to have to write an abstract is for one of the essays. So you can I'll show you how to do an abstract in class. Make sure you capitalize appropriately. And now you can start your essay. But before you get started with that, just to make sure that your running head is operating correctly, give yourself another page. And as you can see, it did everything right. Go to the left there, indent, and then start typing. And now you have an APA template. This page right here would be, if you only had one page or whatever, you could make it your references page. And then you can do all your references on there. What I like to do when I'm writing an APA paper is go ahead and put my references, format them on another document or whatever, and just copy and paste them in. If you have any questions about this, I'm available in class, after class, or before class, or during my office hours, or by appointment. Well, we're going to learn more about this as the course goes along, so have a good day.